when dealing with healing work, when dealing with awakening to true divine nature, when awakening, or when dealing with anything that has to do with the spiritual journey, it's a matter of the heart. And so anything that feels like chaos or anything that is seen as a problem is just what happens when we're interpreting that journey with the mind. The mind's a very effective tool. It's a beautiful tool. It's something that should be constantly reminded of its beauty. The ego is wonderful. We should constantly love the ego for all of it does and how we appreciate it. But a spiritual journey is a matter of the heart, and we're always going to find difficulty. We're always going to find resistance when we're going about it with anything but the heart. The heart is the space within all of us that simply loves. It can love everything from a grain of sand to a piece of lint unconditionally in the way that it loves God itself. And so the heart has the capacity to love any single thing as it loves all things. And it can love the most insignificant thing in the way that it would love the universe itself. And so the love is this ever-present capacity of unconditional love that can flow through the body. And yet it has all the love to give, but isn't necessarily in charge of delivering the love to all the places that love wishes to go. The breath, on the other hand, is the delivery system that delivers the love of the heart into the place of awareness in the body. Sometimes awareness will be on, there's a blockage in my chest in the heart chakra. Sometimes the blockage will be in a pain I feel in my spine. Sometimes the blockage will be in my head where I have a headache. It can manifest physically, emotionally, or whatever. But awareness is what within us brings the mind back to the focus of wherever the disturbance is, wherever the resistance is, wherever the problem is physically, emotionally, or whatever. The solution makes this moment a matter of the heart. We take a deep breath, allowing the breath itself to be like the delivery truck that picks up the shipment of love from the open heart. And the breath itself only knows how to go to the heart and to wherever needs the love that the heart is able to give. So the breath is what goes to the heart, picks up the love, and delivers it to wherever awareness is focusing on the problem or the resistance. And so in that, we get a very simple, simple practice of whenever we find ourselves feeling resistance, whenever we find ourselves feeling emotionally out of balance, whenever we find ourselves not feeling peace, then that in itself is a chance for awareness to direct the breath into the heart with a single deep inhalation, filling the breath itself with all the love life can offer and delivering it to wherever awareness may be focusing. We breathe into whatever the disturbance is, we breathe into the resistance, we breathe into the conflict, and we deliver the love and acknowledge that the love has been delivered with an exhale. The acknowledgement that the love has been delivered is always acknowledged with an exhale, which is why when you sigh, you can only sigh as you exhale. The sigh itself is almost the, love has been delivered. And it's in that breath that delivers love to awareness, whether on a physical level, emotional level, or even a psychological level, that remains the only answer. An answer not of what satisfies the mind with content, but an answer that gives the mind permission to let go of the question. So when a question arises, when a disturbing thought appears, when an emotional feeling that disturbs us arises, anything that happens on whatever level, we answer it with a breath. Anything that I could ever have a problem with is reminding me that it's time for me to use my breath to deliver some love to my body, to my mind, wherever it needs to go. So I'm not lost in the mind trying to figure out a way to solve the problem with more imagination. It's just a time to breathe and deliver love to where it needs to go. This moment is not one filled with a problem. It's just a chance for me to love what has yet to be loved before. And the breath is what delivers that love to the awareness of what we keep in focus. So we breathe.